Hello viewers, I'm back with the presidency from State House on the Civilian Broadcasting Corporation, SLBC, where we go beyond just the ordinary daily news reports about the office of the president. My name is Hawa Mosiri. This week's edition, President Shida Smadabio launches new airport terminal project and justifies the need for infrastructure investment.
Now we're not going to see why we get airport, but we still say under the new direction, we forget a better airport.
United States impressed with Sierra Leone's performance on 2020 MCC scorecard and congratulates President Shida Smadabio on anti-corruption commission accomplishments.
The scorecard and to congratulate the government and the people of Sierra Leone for passing not just passing the scorecard but actually passing by 13 of the indicators. As you can see, 13 of them are green.
President Shida Smadabio addresses an African Development Conference on engaging diaspora Africans and highlights major national efforts.
Africa has a young and rising consumer population and a large potential market of 1.2 billion people that is suitable for different potential diaspora investment portfolios and scales.
These and more lined up for you in this edition of the presidency. Viewers, guess what? President Shida Smadabio has stated that the airport is the true reflection of the people and their level of development. The reason he decided to transform the Lunga International Airport. The president made this statement during the turning of the sword for the construction of the new airport terminal at Freetown International Airport. After the construction of the terminal, up to 1 million passengers will pass through the airport every year. This makes Sierra Leone a major transit hub in the sub-region, particularly for passengers coming or going to South America. The president said Sierra Leone has the shortest distance to South America from Africa, about 6 hours flying time. Addressing hundreds of citizens at the Lunga International Airport, President Shida Smadabio highlighted that his government made a commitment to develop the airport transport market. His administration, who went on, believes in job creation, boosts new sector of growth, tourism, supports trade, and attracts new investment streams. Before COVID, according to President Bill, Lunga served just under 200,000 passengers a year. Although the runway, taxiways, and aprons are in good shape, for an international airport, it should be in better shape.
President, Madam First Lady, Ministers, Deputy Ministers, Members of Parliament, the development partners, the Paramount Chiefs, them, people of Sierra Leone and the youth of Sierra Leone, and Kafu Bulo. Topenoir. On 40, we come and we go and also. Well, Kafu Bulo and Sef need for talk now. Today they need for talk. But I think, say, the chief don't begin talk for them. Because we own politician. What with the work, we still get your own reward. And not what they not come on a Kafu Bulo and or put loco. Anytime where I meet put loco and Kafu Bulo, I remind them. Now of late, give you one counselor. Me, I don't give them nearly two vice presidents them. One, the APC be take them. The other one, they not take them. So now make we get Julia Jallo as the Vice President. Our partners, please allow me to talk to the greater majority of our people in our local parliaments. Because what we can't talk about today, the English word they know they, we go describe them. The last time we didn't do proper makeup of this airport, that be 1967. Most of you young men, they're waiting now, so they not be done born yet. Well, under the new direction, we don't make that possible, no, so. On 40, the new direction itself, or me wait him up now, for be president today, plenty man is a dream. But today na reality, no, so. Dream when we have been think about Lungen Airport being a truly international airport, they can be, and we not say they can see them. Yes. They be saying not gonna be no so. You see, we not talk about it. Now new airline don't begin can see. Yeah, idea. We not arrange them all. Wait, now God now arrange this one. For make when I see, say, wait till what they can do, and for better salon. Wait till make we be cancel the Mamama project. In any case, Mamama, if you see the inside for local, not so. But how long it will look like without this airport? Kafu Bulan, how it will look like without this airport? Some of we not born Naya, but we grew up Naya. So we know waiting the airport me for Kafu Bulom and for Pudloko. So why you they take over 300 million, you go put another part of Pudloko, where you get one, where you go in Kubunam, then you do transport link between here and Freetown. We not be sense in that, and we not want to take that loan there and put on our head because I'm get for pay, but that make we talk say, we go work with Suma. We say then go bring the money, 270 million United States dollars, and can build airport and operate them. When they don't, they give you the airport. And this airport here, with the bottom panam, now they handle about 200,000 to 300,000 down the set with the strain. Where Suma done for Bilam, it will handle 1 million passengers per year. So that is not the only increased revenue, but in the increased job facilities for we young man where they are this part of the country. When we talk about behavior, we where they are, we where they receive the people the way they come. We therefore make sure say anybody where they enter, you see that smiling face. It gets a responsible behavior and professional behavior from Una. So with the appeal to Una, the airport workers, by the way, the arrangement we will make for COVID, before I forget, the arrangement we will make for COVID Naya, even the leading countries not get her. Now the airport Naya, we get one of the best arrangements for handle COVID situation. Many people, we don't travel Naya, we don't pass through Naya, we don't go to England and America say, when a system not even near, the system not even near Una. So I want for make Una know say, we can do an asalom. Yes. Now lazy no more we lazy. And a bad habit, and we get for drop that habit today. Actually at the beginning of this week, the American they can compile one thing, where they show how countries and they develop. The MCC Corporation don't come up for tell we say, when we become the pauper government, we meet with corruption scale, which will be the score. Now 49. This year, they say now 81 now. That one day, 9 day call say a weapon also. A weapon, baby, we weapon, not so. We will talk and we will do them. You know what that means? We all the examine, we said, and person where they grow, you know they know. Now other person tell you say they grow. Now America, one corporation where they examine what thing they happen, per corruption, per water business, per education, per plenty side them, and they talk say that true. Even with the COVID, where we they struggle and we don't know what thing for do. Salon don't make progress. And pandemic corruption in particular, besides the fact that we don't ever since they start for examines alone, now the first time this will get 13 over 17. We not reach distinction yet, but I don't challenge the minister. They say next time, we'll score card to come out. Now distinction, because now that we deserve and that we for. Make where they can make longer airport because now the gateway is for enter inside salon. However you pull, who say people then they first enter, then for not say you descend and you get a development mind now you age. So now that make this not a bluff, now a necessity, and it also they lead to increase in economic activity, it open the country, it help tourism, and they bring about a lot of other things then. So we want for Mekuna no say, we, they always think about what's good. The other one, mama, it not been good for we. Now that's, you get host, then you go build other host, now that's it they take for me that host. Now the deaths, now you go kill the picking them, and we not gonna die. So this building, whether the terminal, with it, then they come, the company, they work on the terminal, they work on the apron down at this space where they before here, the runway outside the plane, then they land, and also for make sure, say, where the plane they land, they can come on at the runway, so that if any other plane they come, then go able to taxi and come back now here. So we they improve and change, wait till now they see so now here. But before this time, as the minister say, we don't make sure, say, we don't improve. When I see the new fire engine, you know so? Waiting with man called navigation at 8 then. Waiting they make the plane land and take off. The technology where they happen for landing and take off safely. The runway lights then. Emergency system, ambulance system at the airport. We don't change all of that on the now make we airport see the function and we get all the airline that they come. So now we now go see why we get airport, but we still say under the new direction we forget a better airport. So wait a minute, we go through all of this. We for done the bear with this, but possibly your image as a country, Sierra Leone. Even when we small, we for do big things there, and we able to do big things there. This arrangement, they not be the thing about it, because they not be the thing for the people. We, they always and continue for think about the people. This not a government with a difference. Now, Combra government is. The jobs and wages they can create now, yeah? Now 2,000 young men there and women there. Now they get for the work, where the construction they go on. 2,000 directly. We get woman there, where as a result of that kind 2,000 number there, we get woman then, we go for the cook, other businesses then there. So directly 2,000 people then, 9 suma get for employed for bill. And I tell when I say now over 1 million capacity, you know, so that means say, even the one that we get for the work now the airport. Let us say because when they say that then they run them, and then they bring people them more. No. Now we young people then with the train for make them walk at the airport. So today, now big day for Lunge and Potloko. Potloko need for rise to the occasion. Because we don't give them plenty thing there. Potloko then get a very good vice president now. The last time, if APC be wins, they'll not be forget vice president. From where Esaku Madai. We see them greedy now. Now take one, not for the girl, not till again. Go to the MP then. Me, I don't give you a Twitter, no, so. Put lock up. Me, I de watch the box system. Put lock up. Put lock up. I go watch the box system. Cheat them. APC no one give you nothing. Who's can work on the work? You know what they say? They say Poloko na bulldozer. Where they make road, where they take them to map, the bulldozer, and then they can clear. The way the road don't make now, where they put the bulldozer, they find one more to car. They say, man, up where the road, they put it inside the car and go far. Then green eye can't do again, oh. That I work, then I put Poloko, they do. We they tell when I say we're not a bulldozer then. Now this way they say, now this I've been on say. I don't know if I need for talk to me for make when I understand this one. We're not a bulldozer. We're not a bulldozer. Well, for waiting I expect say when I get for do in future, may I begin say Momo no. Momo no. So me don't give you a first again also. I don't give you a first, I don't give you a second. I don't tell you a thank you in anticipation. that thank you, I don't give you a good take and almost so. When I get for act. Where we talk, we do another so. We not don't get Napodloco. One of the biggest farm there. The most modernized farm. Narombe. If they can't start. But local they produce a lot of rice, but one for make sure say now we help the people then so that they go produce more rice and benefit farmer not for be purpose. Farming for be a lucrative business for everybody, especially the one the way they do it. So government they support. But that one where we talk about the Rombe project, now one where now about 14,000 hectares. Where we don't bring people then, where they can show how for plant rest, we afford them per year, so that this rest on our leg, we go get them. We go to produce your rest. One thing they want me to try, I don't know if you're going to support me in this country. You're going to support me? You're going to support me? I want me to stop for each rest for 3 days no more. Una support me? Una support me? Hey. Now 3 days, I'm doing 9 days and then for eat cassava, we eat yam, plantain. You know what you do? That thing where the economics them quick, they say foreign exchange, not the, I make this the rice, this the rice. If we stop for each restaurant for 3 days, we eat all the other food then. Foreign exchange go then at this country. 3 days no more per the week. Just eat cassava, fundi, anything. But I tell you, I don't to answer, but we're not agree. The youth man they will agree. Okay. So what we come for now today, now really just to make a launch this project, where we don't come for and where we know say go benefit. Especially the young man then, the 2,000 where they employ, and the many thousands where they go employ where the airport spoken naya. So I glad for them naya, and I now get the pleasure for formally launch this airport rehabilitation and refurbishment under SUMAC group of companies, and we will come back now for celebrate. Then give it only 2 years. I know SUMAC. What they say, they say na talk and do. Suma group, na talk and do. They say 2 years, not so. In 2 years, we go come back now, and we go see a beautiful structure, a beautiful airport, and we go celebrate because Lunge, don't come on a bush now. The lie by Lunge, it go down, not so. Plenty of people don't lie for now, but we not get for lie for now. Because the SIPP, Now truly Kumbra Party and they think about everyone. So on that note, at the time, I'd like to thank you and Gladi for coming formally launch this project today. Thank you.
The Suma Group, he said, will bring its own money, design, builds, operates and transfer. The group is also operating in other airports in the ECOWAS region. The chairman of the Office of the President on Infrastructure Initiative stated that new approach is a new way of rapidly implementing major infrastructure projects through its own office.
Our distinctive government experience in UAE is a good example of what can be done when God blesses a country with an unselfish leadership that strives for the good of his people and not his own. Dubai is an example of what can be done when God blesses a country with good leadership. Ladies and gentlemen, today, here in Lunga, Kafmulam Chiefdom, and for the rest of Sierra Leone, we are witnessing a display of leadership that strives for the good of his people and not for his own selfishness. In the person of His Excellency, Brigadier Retired Dr. Yusuf Agyo. Just so that I know, say, not the new people of Green Camp, that people who don't build airport, they don't operate airport, and they don't do a good, very, very good job.
Minister of Transport and Aviation Kabinet Kalon described the day as significant because government recognizes air transport as key to economic development, as increased airport capacity can raise productivity in other sectors of the economy such as tourism and investment. As increased transport capacity can raise productivity in other sectors of the economy such as tourism and investment. He disclosed that in March 2019, a gap analysis on African aviation infrastructure was conducted in line with ACAO Council decision.
I'm delighted and grateful that signing of the contract to commence the construction of a terminal status starts during my tenure. Today, gathering is a significant because this government recognizes air transport as key economic development. An increased airport capacity can raise productivity in other sectors of the economy, such as tourism and investment. Your Excellency, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I'm pleased to inform you that in March 2019, a gap analysis on African aviation institutions infrastructure was conducted in line with ACAO. With ACAO Council decision, one key decision was to elevate the priorities of the aviation sector in our national development plan. Over the years, a team of experts from Airport Council International participated in an extensive peer review known as APEX, Safety Review of the Facility Procedure Organization of the Freetown International Airport. At the request of the state, APEX safety review was conducted under the ACI for Airport Excellence in Safety Programs. This was to serve as a part of our preparedness for the airport certification, which is a key manifesto policy under your leadership, His Excellency. APEX safety review report highlighted a number of safety deficiencies, which include but not limited to runway pavement cracks, damage to runway shoulders, apron pavement cracks, damage to runway shoulders. Implementation of this project is not only timely, but appropriate for the implementation of the collective action plan.
Deputy Minister of Finance Patricia Nyanga Lavalle noted that the project was designed on a cost recovery basis by the private sector partner. She noted that the financial terms for the project are in line with government's financial objectives.
The financing model used for this transaction is completely
on the land sheet. There is no sovereign guarantee. What does this mean for the media and the opposition, government in one sentence? Okay? We just review the agreement. We look at the deal structure, not the Ministry of Finance. We sit down, of course, cabinet approval, attorney general, then carefully assess the legal dimension and the benefit to the country. So it's at no cost to government. The developer, Sumo Group, will build, now then they build, Sumo Group, now then they build, now then they operate, then they transfer on to government. But for now, we want it already. Thank you very much. This BOT agreement has been rigorously scrutinized by us, of course, Ministry of Transport, Justice. I'd like to mention that the Ministry of Planning and Economic Development was also involved in the review of the project documents. The Ministry of Tourism and Cultural Affairs was also involved, as well as the Ministry of Works and Public Assets. We collectively reviewed the project document to ensure cost effectiveness. Okay? We collectively agree to the activity then where the developer they provide, and we agree say the cost effective. Currently, at the moment, we know they make better money at the airport. So, with this new terminal, we hope that with the increased air traffic passenger volumes, we in our government will significantly see an increase in the volume of revenue where they come out na airport. It is our hope that after this new terminal is constructed, we will be all compliance with the ICAO standards and recommended best practices. This will help us to ensure airport safety and make our airport an attractive aviation and air transport destination.
Minister of Northwestern Region, Haja Aissatou Kamara, commended President Julius Madabio for putting words into action.
On behalf of the people of the Northwest region, and especially with the people of Odloko district, we want to thank Almighty God for choosing you, sir, to become the president of this nation. Today marks another historic milestone for all Sierra Leoneans to witness the landmark development in Kafobulom in Odloko district. Your Excellency, you rally around the whole country, sending a manifesto to the people. Majority believed in you. Majority believed in you. Those who believed in you voted for you because God has asked you to be the next president, and indeed you are. You won the election because of the votes the Lunga people gave you during the runoff. The votes in Lunga were protest votes. The people protested because their only livelihood was about to go under the carpet. Sierra Leone is synonymous to Lunga, and moving the livelihood of hundreds and thousands of people would have been a disaster. You promised them that if they vote you in, the airport will stay. Allah answered the prayers of our pastors and imams. And indeed, today, is the day Allah has chosen for that promise to be fulfilled. We want to say thank you. Mr. President, your generosity, kindness, love for country is exemplary. The love you showed to us in Potloko district is second to none. You gave us the Vice President, Dr. Mohammed Jule Dejalo. The Speaker of Parliament, Dr. Abbas Bundu, although by legislation, they have moved to Karen district. You break the male dominance bond by making me the first female resident minister in Sierra Leone. A few weeks ago, you opened the unique first female government school in Potloko district. The bundle of developmental package is evidently unfolding. We want to say thank you. Mr. President, what you are about to launch today will definitely showcase, attract, and map out this region in the archives of development. There is going to be a rapid change in demography of this country. We are about to experience massive urban-rural migration. Our land will become our valuable assets, and our unique culture will help to promote tourism. There is tendency for rapid growth, and we are looking forward for the next unbundling, which will automatically signal the establishment of a new city in Lungi.
Paramount Chief of Kafu Bulum Chiefdom and the board chairman of Lunga International Airport also appreciated the government for the expansion projects.
Now the people of Kafu Bulum, they give this message. Your Excellency, the chairman and cabinet minister, you will come and sign and commission the expansion of the international airport. The people of Kafu Bulum, they can a large number for come with me if it are true. Now I say, to me, the number one person a president of this country, that somebody will be saying, stand by his words. But before I go further, I go out for all that join me. Not only the people of Kafu Bulum, but the people of Potloko district. For me to welcome, we honor the owner, the president of this country, which is a woman, and we all go that owner, the vice president, then come with well body, but turn back with well body. Your Excellency, the people in Kafu Bulum, they say, you know, do no mistake, For can expand this airport. Then so we say this plan not to today get them. If we don't get them, the term will be the work now as a soldier. Now if we don't develop this plan, for say, if he be president of this country, he will make the people of Kafu Bulum be happy. And we they tell you say, if we make you happy, who said God for making you happy? And then they say, Lord, say you beaucoup thank you for making you where you hold your brother fine the begin. When in order you vice president, where you hold a fine with one. And for me, they tell you thank you. With all this, where you've been getting planned for coming to this international airport. He said, we go take post in far for can be about chairman of the Sierra Leone Airport Authority. He said, I can't follow me in the Pulang. Oh, no, no less a person, but now we don't go to Bakuna and the Williams.
I bring you greetings from the board and management of Sierra Leone Airport Authority and from the people of Potloko district. The aviation industry in Sierra Leone has been fraught with a growing number of challenges. The existing terminal building is small and cannot adequately accommodate 200,000 passengers passing through Finta International Airport annually. The runway is in a fragile condition, and the entire airport infrastructure, including the taxiway and the apron, requires massive rehabilitation to meet international standards. I want to thank you, HE, and your government for your initiative to maintain and improve on the only one existing international airport in Sierra Leone, located here in Lugé. You promised not to relocate it to Mamama, as indicated in your manifesto and development agenda. Thank you very much. You talk, you do, and unfortunately, you follow, went ahead to initiate the policy of tax reduction on airport charges to create a conducive traveling environment to and from Sierra Leone. You promised to construct a new airport terminal to further improve on the status of our airport to the admiration of the countries in the sub-region and the world at large. Today's event marks the realization of your dream to transform the aviation sector in Sierra Leone. That is, turning off the start for the new airport terminal project to be undertaken by the Suma Group of Coming from Turkey. The board and management of Sierra Leone Airport Authority, the people of Lunge, Port Loko District and Sierra Leone at large are very happy with this power agenda initiative. I want to finally thank Dr. Tambi and his team for making this project a dream come true. Eji, I believe in your slogan that Papa has Salon for better, and I believe that Salon done better. I want to thank you very much.
The gateway to Sierra Leone, a new direction. A new gateway will represent Sierra Leone with a better aspiration.
Sierra Leone is amongst the top 10 performers of control of corruption in its income category. This year, Sierra Leone passed an additional 2 indicators. This is the highest score Sierra Leone has ever scored on the MCC since the scorecard was established, and the first time Sierra Leone has passed the scorecard for 2 years in a row. In the case of control of corruption, Sierra Leone has not only passed the indicator for the past 3 years, it has also made steady progress. In the area of education, Sierra Leone also made great progress on primary education expenditure. Vice President Dr. Mohamed Junde Jallow told President Julius Maada Bio that the MCC team has been working very hard for the past 12 months.
We have been working very hard over the last 12 months. So she's here today with Matt. Matt is the MCC coordinator, and then with Nday, who is the CEO, MCC CEO, Madam Ambassador.
American Ambassador Maria Brewer expressed satisfaction about Spain's performance by scoring 14 indicators.
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you for seeing us this morning, and I have the honor and privilege to formally hand over to you the scorecard and to congratulate the government and the people of Sierra Leone for passing, not just passing the scorecard, but actually passing by 13 of the indicators. As you can see, 13 of them are green. Passing by more, two additional indicators from last year, as well as increasing the control of corruption score to 81% from, I believe, 77 last year. So you
79.
Ah, so good. You know it's
I know the mercy.
Yes, great. So really, you know, not just passing, but really doing a superlative job. So congratulations, Mr. President.
Thank
I'm
you.
So honored to be able to share this news with you today.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
She noted that Sierra Leone is moving in the right direction, as this is the first time the country has made such huge success in terms of passing 13 out of 20 indicators.
Yes, well, today I'm very happy and proud to be able to share with the government of Sierra Leone the scorecard, which, as you see, the government has passed 13 of the indicators, the 20 indicators, actually two more indicators than last year and more than any time in the history. So we're very proud of the government and the people of Sierra Leone, and we encourage them to keep up the good work.
So which area do you think Sierra Leone needs to improve more?
Well, you can see that the various areas where the red is in fiscal policy, access to credit, child health. But even in those areas, very often, again, as you examine the scorecard, you'll see that sometimes the trend is in the right direction. It's just not quite there yet. But you know, when you see things like the control of corruption, which went from 79% to 81% last year to this year, you know, again, we're seeing a trend line in the right direction, and so we hope to see more of the same.
So what would be your message to Sierra Leone in terms of, you know, good governance in other areas where we actually did very well to improve on that, and to actually support the government to do more?
Well, first of all, congratulations, and this is an excellent result. I think one that all Sierra Leoneans can and should be proud of, but that there is more work to be done, and we encourage you, you know, sort of more grease your elbow, you know, more strength as you move forward. So, thank you. I also wanted to point out that this is a U.S. government compilation of information, but the scores themselves are from international and multinational organizations like World Health Organization, World Bank, the UNICEF, and others that are not just American views, but these are truly a multinational set of indicators. So it's not just America's scorecard, but really the world looking at Sierra Leone and saying, you know, good job.
President Julius Maada Bio commended the team for the hard work, adding that the MCC is an objective evaluation of government, especially as it relates to energy and water sectors, which are very important components.
A more objective evaluation of what we are doing, especially as it relates to energy and water, which are very important components. The threshold program has been a great help, and we hope that the foundation laid by the threshold program will have to help us to build on that sector, the two sectors. But the fact that, the MCC score is also an aggregation of different independent groups, for me, I always look forward to seeing how well we are faring on. So thank you very much, and I'm happy. Thank you.
The Millennium Challenge Coordinating Unit Chief Executive Officer Nday Fatou Kourouma said the country's performance was pleasing. Sierra Leone, she disclosed, has made a lot of improvements since last year.
So great that we've made this great accomplishment on passing the MCC scorecard. We have made a lot of improvements from last year, and this is testament to the hard work of many people on ensuring that we continue to promote good governance rule of law and economic freedom in Sierra Leone.
Great improvement in various areas. Can you please highlight?
Yes, the key areas that we have seen improvements include in the area of immunization rates. So Sierra Leone has increased significantly to about 94% immunization rates in Sierra Leone. We also are seeing significant improvements on inflation rates. Sierra Leone was not passing that indicator last year. This year we're seeing Sierra Leone passing. We also are seeing that the increases in the free and quality education that's being provided by the government is also resulting in high expenditures on primary education rates. So these are all areas that we should all be proud of, and to show that the effort that is going into improving, for instance, the lives of our children and giving them opportunity, we're actually seeing that the data is being backed up by some of these kind of international assessments.
The MCC is a United States foreign agency that is helping countries fight widespread poverty through economic growth. Finally, in today's edition of the presidency, the virtual meeting convened by the African Peer Review Mechanism, APRM, a specialized agency of the African Union and the Center for Global Africa at Douala State University in the United States, is also the first global summit on the promotion of agribusiness between the APRM and its people in the diaspora. In his opening remarks of the three-day event, President Julius Madabio said that the focus of the conference on executing joint African diaspora initiative is to accelerate the African Union's agenda 2063 while simultaneously advancing diaspora interests in ways that are problem-solving, capacity-building, revenue-generating and mutually beneficial is something that he values immensely as an African leader. But the conference the president disclosed is also critical because it may help Sierra Leone design, structure and concretize official channels and linkages for unimpeded two-day transactional activities that will help Africa and the sixth region create the Africa they want.
Honorable Mike T. Skews, Secretary of Agriculture in the state of Delaware, United States. His Excellency Joseph Leonel Correa Sacco, Commissioner for Rural Economy and Agriculture of the African Union Commission. Honorable Lana Max, United States Ambassador to the Republic of South Africa. Professor Isra Ahoni, Director of the Center for Global Africa at Delaware State University. Professor Eddie Maloka, CEO of the African Peer Review Mechanism. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, permit me from the outset to thank you for the honor and very unique opportunity as President of the Republic of Sierra Leone to participate and contribute to discussions on the governance and development of the African continent. Africa is home to more than 1 billion people and home away from home, both culturally and historically, however distant or near, for hundreds of millions more in the sixth region. It is a rich and diverse community of resourceful and talented citizens, full of enthusiasm, energy, and great optimism. The sixth region that comprises people of African origin living outside the continent, irrespective of their citizenship and nationality, and who are willing to contribute to the development of the continent and the building of the African Union, is an integral part of the African continent. Its citizens, diaspora Africans, are enablers and driving forces in the socio-economic transformation of Africa as envisaged in the African Union's Agenda 2063. In spite of arguments about how the sixth region of Africa is constituted, represented, or legitimized, I would argue that the sixth region is grounded in the universality of Pan-Africanism. Its agenda and character are pluralistic, globalist, transgenerational, and essentially African. So let me welcome every one of you, distinguished excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, to this second annual CGA APRM Pan-African Development Conference, titled Creating the Africa We Want, Creating the Sixth Region We Want, through agribusiness research and innovation. Let me also congratulate the African Peer Review Mechanism, our homegrown self-assessment instrument of good governance, and the Center of Global Africa for pioneering this initiative. I also recognize further commitments to strengthen the CGA-APRM partnership. The focus of this conference on executing joint African diaspora initiative to accelerate the AU's Agenda 2063, while simultaneously advancing diaspora interests in ways that are problem-solving, capacity-building, revenue-generating, and mutually beneficial, is something that I personally value immensely as an African leader. But this conference is also critical because it may help us design, structure, and concretize official channels and linkages for unimpeded two-way transactional activities that will help Africa and the Sixth Region create the Africa we want. Although the realities of statehood and regional economic formations are inescapable, African leaders should work towards uniformity and clarity of trade, investment, and financial regulations across the continent. They should also identify best practices and therefore design, review, and validate frameworks of engagement with the Sixth Region. We should also institutionalize ways of transforming Sixth Region remittances into investment funds that could serve various growth sectors across the continent. In most of our countries, we are working towards establishing a structured and firm bedrock for inclusive and sustainable development. In Sierra Leone, for instance, our medium-term national development plan lays out our development priorities that are more on human capital development, access to free quality education, quality health, and food security. We also recognize that we can reduce poverty by creating jobs, lower import dependency, and enhance food security if we invest heavily in the agribusiness sector. Structured Sixth Region financing and expertise can support the transfer of diaspora resources, skills, and expertise, and thus develop capacity and knowledge transfer, establish growth centers and incubation hubs, and promote value addition and local manufacture. We should not also lose sight of the potential of a structured triangular cooperation nexus among countries. The Sixth Region and multilateral institutions that could support diaspora investments in agribusiness. We should also recognize that the fourth industrial revolution, with its implications for global trade and development, is upon us. Africa cannot afford to be at the receiving end as it was during the first, second, and third industrial revolutions. Africa should be an equal and active participant and partner. Our investment in human capital development is underpinned by this objective. Governments have a responsibility in that regard to establish the right context that will facilitate diaspora investment in innovation and technology. In Sweden, for instance, I established a directorate of science, technology, and innovation to explore, develop, and deploy technology and innovation to scale in order to support governance, business, healthcare, and research. This institution is a local partner that has worked with governments, multilateral agencies, and the private sector to develop innovative technology-mediated solutions for Sierra Leone, including in managing the COVID-19 pandemic. But I also see potential for six-region investment in knowledge transfer, innovation, and technology entrepreneurship that we develop bespoke solutions that address Africa's development challenges. So this conference is tasked with three key but interrelated tasks. How do we identify the opportunities? How do we structure linkages and investment interventions? And how do we create a conducive win-win ecosystem to support inclusive and sustainable development in Africa? Let me once more thank the APRM under the leadership of the APRM Continental Secretariat and its CEO, Professor Eddie Maloka. I wish to commend and thank Professor Maloka for his stellar work in championing the second ANA CGA APRM Pan-African Development Conference. Let me also commend the commitment and the aims of the CGA under the leadership of Professor Isra Aharoni for the support of the APRM and the African development throughout America's historically black colleges and universities and other diaspora stakeholders. My country supports these dialogues and initiatives about Africa's development, and my country is ready to work with the APRM, the CGA, and other partners in that regard. The Africa we have may not be the Africa we want, but by engaging all stakeholders, creating conducive environment for exploring possibilities and fostering real ideas, structuring and deepening linkages and dialogue around Africa's development, we, the sixth region and Africa, may create the Africa that we want. I wish you all fruitful deliberations. God bless Africa. God bless the sixth region of Africa. And thank you for your attention.
Well, viewers, that's all we have for you in this edition of the Presidency. Thanks for your company, and I'm glad you could join me. My name is Awa Mosiri, and I'll be back next week here from State House with more about the work of the President and his lieutenants in the new direction administration. Make sure you continue to adhere to all COVID-19 precautionary measures to keep your community safe. Do have a blessed Sunday.